Hello MechWarriors, how is it going? Welcome back to BattleTech! Today we try our new toys. We got a Battlemaster and we got a Highlander and I've set them up in some different kind of ways. And I want to show you how. Let's take a look at our beauty here. So the Highlander. The Highlander was coming with a Gauss rifle, an LRM-20++, an SRM-6++ and 3 medium lasers. And as you can see, it's kind of the same thing still. But I think you do not need all the double heatsinks for the build. You can actually just drop some and take standard heatsinks as a backup here. Also, I was going for almost maximum armor here and I built in a Gyro +++ with +3 hit defense. This is so cool. Or I believe it's so cool because it gives you 3 chevrons, 3 like evasive chevrons. It's harder to hit permanently, and I want to use this mech as a mech that is constantly active, jumping around, taking shots at specific targets and taking them out precisely. That's my idea here. So let's see if that works. I do not rely too much on Bulwark and staying in one position. This is gonna be my active mech here. Also, I've got a cockpit mod which helps resisting injuries, +2. So the first 2 injuries that you get in a mission are just completely negated by the cockpit mod. That's super, super handy. Now you ask, what did I do with the other heat sinks that I pulled out of this? I put them in the Battlemaster. The Battlemaster has a problem. Although, what? Ah, not refit. Ah, stop. Yeah, sure, I want to refit. The Battlemaster has a problem because it can load a lot of weapons, but it doesn't really have enough weight to put enough heat sinks in there. And as you can see, we are boating 7 medium lasers here, and we brought in the 3 double heat sinks coming out of the Highlander to keep the mech cold. So this is relatively efficient, and I put in a backup weapon, an LRM-20++ in here, because I want use my Battlemaster as the frontliner, but until he gets there, he needs to do something. And therefore, indirect fire from the LRMs, and we of course get some more stability damage in, which helps knocking enemies over, pushing back in initiative and such, and that's really cool. So on top of it, we have a gyro, +2 melee hit. So again, I want to bring him close and then punch people. And then we have the comp system for +2 morale gain here, because I didn't have another cockpit mod here. Therefore, we take this. And that's the Battlemaster. Apart from it, we still have our Thunderbolt, which has 2 LRM-15++ and a bunch of medium lasers. And of course, the Orion with our AC-10++, the SRMs and the medium lasers. So the Orion and the Battlemaster are gonna be my frontliner. Then we have the mobile jumping Highlander, which can intercept. And of course, our second liner, the Thunderbolt. I've negotiated already a contract here, so we are trying to extract somebody from a pirate facility. It's a recovery mission with 3.5 skulls, and yeah, I think the setup here is already nice. So this is it, we have Glitch. Glitch is an ace pilot. That means she can move after shooting, which is super handy on a mech that can jump around. So I want to bring her into position. I want to, again, precisely bring or alpha strike somebody out and then get back to cover. So we have a lot of evasion here, and getting the ace pilot on top of it is super good. We have Kevlar in the Orion, as per usual, Bulwark and Breaching Shot, and Tactic 9. Tactic 9 is super good because she has now the increased effectiveness of Cold Shot, which makes it so that we might be able to kill somebody with a headshot with our AC-10, because it deals 70 damage and the cockpit only has 61 hit points. Let's try this, maybe in this mission. Warpuff being my frontliner, Battlemaster with Juggernaut. He wants to run to the front and punch people out of time, pushing him back 1 initiative turn. So that's the idea here. And then Behemoth, of course, with the multi-target, with Bulwark being our second liner. Let's get into the mission here. It's gonna be a lot of fun to play. So we play an extract mission. That means that we have to go into a specific area, get an objective. I think it's a person of interest here. And then we have to extract that to another spot. And in the meantime, we are fighting our way through waves of mechs and vehicles, I believe. We're gonna see how it works and how it goes down. And I'm very, very excited trying out the new stuff. I think the build is reasonable. And that is it. Retrieve operations and biological samples and escape. We need you to recover our operatives from inside a pirate research facility. They will be carrying highly sensitive scientific materials which must be returned to us. These materials are of biological nature and must be tampered with. must not be tampered with. Opening or tampering with the materials will be considered a breach of contract. All right, let's get in there. Your target is a pirate research facility. You'll be recovering restoration operatives carrying biological sample cases. They are ready for extraction when your unit reach the facility. Pick them up and get them to the evac point. Best of luck, Commander. Okay, can do. Oh wait, let's get a little overview of what we are going up against. Secure the secondary facility to rescue the operatives. Secure the facility to collect the sample. This is the main thing. Oh, and look at this. This is in a valley here. Oh, interesting. And wait, do I have to go over here? There was a little blip over there. Secure the secondary facility to rescue. Okay, we have to go over there. That means that we go into this general direction and we just sprint in. That's the thing. I think the first, like, one or two moves, we do not encounter anybody. So let's be quick about it. By the way, the plan today is to... to try to get two missions done today. That would be cool.
I'm there.
Wait, how do I get down there?
Got it.
There's a ramp. Okay, so we have a ramp here, but we also have our Highlander that can just jump around like crazy. Okay, there's a vehicle down there. It's in 60 tonner. Alright. Good to know. And now the battle started. It's okay that the Thunderbolt is here. A little bit further in the back. That's alright. And I think I want to reserve. I want to see if there's something coming up. And then try to take it out directly. I mean, the vehicle... They cannot guard or brace or anything, so if I jump to the front now, trying to get line of sight to this guy, I should be able to take it out directly. Well, this is weird. I can see him, but I can only fire indirectly. Okay. I need to do a turn, anything. To get him moving. Ah, oh, we do this. Yeah, let's go. Let's bring Kevlar in. Kevlar with the AC-10 and the mediums. Second vehicle here. Alright. It's a Manticore. Manticore is in shoddy condition. Weak against melee, of course. But still. Still dangerous. I can only shoot my AC here. Alright. Wondering if I should brace in this scenario. It's PPC, LRM, SRM, medium laser. I do not want to take too much damage right now, and only bringing the AC is just stretching it, I guess. A cold shot to the side would be just enough. Shall we take our luck here? We have super high morale. 88% hit chance. It's fire. No. What? Hey! Did I do... What? Was that Baramath? Did I my math wrong? He has 1 HP left? I should have dealt 70 damage. And if I saw that correctly, he wasn't at exactly 7 hit points.
Receiving you.
Ah, what's that? What's that? Anyway, we have two vehicles to do something. I'm gonna shoot him. I'm gonna shoot him from over here. Yeah. And try to hit him with one LRM. One LRM needs to hit. I mean, Manticores are kind of scary, the PPC and the LRMs, they deal some good damage here. So, we engage from all of the sides, that's good. No need for a precision strike, hopefully. Let's see. One hit to the side, please. Good, thank you. Okay. So Kevlar is kind of safe. And the good thing is that now I hope that the other vehicle is coming in and it gets shot with the Gauss rifle. There's another thing. What's that? It's 80-ton vehicles. Lots of vehicles here. I was hoping for some mechs to salvage, but the mission a little bit quicker then. Because I think I can deal with vehicles very, very well here. You're gonna brace. And then Warpath. Warpath is gonna sprint. Yeah, I want Warpath down there and fight. Battlemaster needs to be on the front line. Also, the Battlemaster is next to the Highlander, the mech with the most armor in my lands right now. Okay, what do we have here? Another Manticore. Alright. And some medium mechs on the left side. Yeah. Let's deal with the tanks first, because, again, they are easier to destroy. Ah, Trebuchet. Ow. Ow. Could you not? That hurts. Ow. Trebuchet? Yeah, 50 ton. Lots of LRMs. Trebuchet and a cicada. I could split up my forces here. Just use the Orion to deal with the left side and use the other ones to deal with the right side. We're gonna see about this. So the Manticore is one of my priority targets here. AC5, I believe. 55 ton. Wolverine. Shadowhawk, maybe. 80 ton vehicle. This is scary. Like, this could be a Demolisher. Double AC20. So we're gonna get the jump on this guy. Anyway. Behemoth. Behemoth gonna do precision strike to the guy. Or Kevlar. Kevlar moving up here. Kevlar needs to move. No, doesn't need to move. Just bulwark here. Never mind. I have an idea. Okay. This is what we do. We need to get evasive off of the cicada. This guy is super evasive. So we multi-target. We just shoot him. 1, 2. And get one of the evasive Tevron off. This should also work against cover, I believe. Wait. Breaching shot. Attacks with a single weapon ignore cover and guarded on the target. So it doesn't really show. Oh, wait. Now. Now it shows. Sure. Multi-target properly. Okay, let's go.
Copy that.
So, just some damage to the Manticore, just softening that thing up, so that we can do the precision strike and get a reliable pinpoint damage in. And we get one evasive off the Cicada and get some damage in. So nice. There's a heavy. Oh, the 80-tonner is acting in initiative turn 2. And it's shooting. It's a Shrek. Oh crap, we need to deal with the Shrek immediately. Because as long as he has line of sight to us, he can shoot his PPCs, and it's 3 of them without generating heat. This is the thing. PPCs on a tank are super scary. I have to bring in Glitch and just pressure this guy. Hard.
Commander?
Okay, so now we can stay here. Do we precision strike actually? We can just kill this guy. That's it. I don't need to fiddle around with this. Do I? I mean, if we kill him now, we get some morale back, so why not do it? Let's do it.
Gotcha.
Yeah, it was definitely the right call. And there's a mech off the battlefield. I think that's just valuable here. And my other pilots, like Glitch, they still have this bug. I'd rather not play with the bug. Like, the Glitch is in permanent high spirits as well as Behemoth here. It's when you... Some people said that it is when you have an event that gives you high spirits for a specific time, and then add a skill on top, or unlock a skill on that pilot, it will be permanent afterwards. Again, might be a glitch, but it's just the way it is right now. So the Manticore being pushed back, or it is in the last initiative turn there, so we bring in the Battlemaster now. Alright. I just want to break line of sight to everybody. Or just kill them so that they cannot have that this guy cannot have any targets. Do we Alpha Strike? We have the heat and we are in the water soon. So let's go, yeah.
All weapons committed.
I think the medium lasers are enough already. Yes. Exactly. Alright. Manticore of the battlefield. So, more morale here. Nice. And now, we have Glitch. Hey Glitch,
waiting for order.
Can you get a jump? Down there. Sprinting doesn't do more. Yeah. She can, however, try to sprint up here and then jump over here and get an angle. She could flank the guy. Jumping doesn't do too much here, apart from getting massive evasion. Sprinting, however. I wonder if I can jump here. No, I just want to jump down there. Let's play it safe.
I leap, I soar.
So it's such a great line. I leap, I soar. So good. Alrighty. So the Trebuchet needs to come in now and gets his own line of sight. He's alpha striking my Orion, just getting a lot of damage in. But I'm very happy that I was guarded here. So. No damage, or just little damage. What's this? It's a Wolverine. Yeah, as I thought. AC5, some mediums, and an SRM6. So the Orion again is super, super tanky. He can just stand there. Or she can just stand there and do nothing.
Standing by.
Alright. This is exactly what we do here. So, wanna get the trap out first. Since... Oh, shall we go for the headshot here? Let's go! 18% hit chance. It could be that the trebuchet is getting one shot. And if not, the damage will go to the center torso, which is fine for me as well. Let's go.
All weapons are go.
Yeah, not enough. The good thing is that the pirates are here in a shoddy condition, so see that? Even if I do not hit my cold shot properly, I deal so much damage. So much damage. Oh, Shrek is coming in. Not good, not good, not the battle master. So much pinpoint. And stability damage on top of it. Okay. Now I can probably do whatever I want. So you stay here. Shall I go closer? I cannot bring in my mediums. Shrek first? How does he look? Wow, he's super squishy. Okay, I think... I'm doing a risky move here. I think, though, that we can afford doing this. Do we actually need this? Yeah, let's go for it. Roger. Let's just kill the guys. I do not need a trebuchet. There's no need for me to just try to salvage it. Or maybe I should. What is this? 4 HP! Could you not? Oh wait, who's that? Who's shooting me? There's something in the back. That wasn't the trap. The trap has no weapons anymore. There was something here. Interesting. Alrighty. Yeah. I do not get a line of sight, but Glitch is probably... Yeah, she's able to do it. I can jump on this little rock here. Or I could just be in the water... Water? It's only indirect. Okay. Okay. I thought I could hit this guy. Now, of course, we jump into the water because of the heat management. And, I might have done it wrong. Anyway, since we only can fire indirectly, we shoot the LRMs to this guy. And one weapon to this guy, and then he should be dead. And then we have C. So this is super multi-target. B. Exactly. So we need... Well, that's 4 damage. The SRM should be enough. Could also shoot the mediums. And then the Gauss rifle to C. So A, B, C. Let's go.
Got it.
Probably don't kill this guy. Oh, we are close though. So that's nice. Structure exposed on the front. This should be a kill. Yes, of course. And now, the Wolverine. Bam! That's an impact. I like the Gauss. This is so cool. Also, it doesn't generate too much heat, only 5 heat, that's nothing. Aha! Another tank! So it is not over yet. Alrighty. The problem is that I have direct line of sight here. And wherever I go with the... Oh, wait. With the Battlemaster. Damn it. Okay, I'm gonna stay here, using my Bulwark ability, and hope for the LRM-20s to hit something. We don't need much. It's not enough. Right. Alright. That's fair. It's okay. I mean, why not have a challenge? Alright. This is like 7 damage in the side and 3 on the front. Can I please kill the Shrek? Because it's gonna shoot next turn. I have one chance. I'm gonna take Behemoth then. Bringing her closer makes sense to me. She has multi-target, so bringing in the mediums to the Wolverine. Ah, and there's the second mech. It's a 75-ton mech. Oh, that might be an Orion. That is an Orion. Definitely. Yeah, that's an Orion. Maybe we can get another Orion. We're gonna see about this. So, multi-target AB. One LRM should be enough. Hopefully.
Splitting fire.
I count on you, Behemoth. You need one hit. Either to the side or to the front. Good. And then the Wolvie, of course. I like this setup so much. Like the Thunderbolt. Even if you run out of ammo, still. Late game, you have 4 medium lasers. And that's cool. Okay, my next objectives are... Not dying. Okay, okay. Yeah.
I'm taking heavy hits, Commander.
Bringing Orion to the front. That's it. That's it. We have a lot of armor. And we can just rely on that. Now, bulwark or not. No, we move forward. I want to bring the Orion in front of the Thunderbolt. I want to kill the Wolverine. The Wolverine is not doing anything anymore, probably. And then next turn, I'm gonna bulwark Kevlar. So hopefully that the Orion will shoot then the other Orion. So fight of the Orions. No mediums here. Only the SRMs and the AC. Headshot. No. Precision strike. Center torso. Kill.
Taking the shot.
Making a safe call here. Sure. Good.
Enemy eliminated.
Guys, I try. What I'm doing here is I try to play a little bit faster so that we can get another mission in. That's my plan right now. So bringing the Orion to the front, trying to destroy the Wolverine was a measure of accelerating the game a little bit. So of course, if I would play it super safe, I would have left him in the back and or her in the back and not bring her to the front. Because of she has bulwark and everything and can shoot indirectly, but that would again stretch out the game so much. And I want to get on another mission. That's my reasoning behind this here, just to give you some context. What's this vehicle? 80 tons. Might be another Shrek, might be a Demolisher, double AC-20. I could just stay here, shoot the Gauss rifle and the LRM. I could make a precision strike. Gauss rifle deals 75 damage, 5% hit chance. Now my reasoning is maybe I get to salvage this guy. I want to take my chances on this. Let's see. Of course, Santa Torso would be more efficient. I'm just trying to get stability damage in and getting a headshot here, but it didn't work. And here's the cool thing, guys. Now we can just jump around freely after shooting. So I could go back to cover. Like, okay, there's no cover here, but you get the point, right? So what I want to do is I want to intercept this guy on the right side.
No sweat.
Therefore, we are repositioning already. Nice. Look at the evasive, and then plus 3 from the gyro. She's not gonna get hit by anything. Battlemaster trying to battle to the front. Wait for us, guys. I'm coming. Now this mission is very bad for our Battlemaster here. So getting into position is really hard. And I mean, I still have the LRM-20. I wanted to be in the center of the map because I thought there was the biggest fight happening, that there were a lot of mechs down there, but it didn't work. And in this scenario, I'm super happy that I got my long-range missile 20. Having the backup weapon to shoot indirectly when you're out of position is so crucial. Of course, I should have could have gotten an AC-10 as well, which would be also a nice weapon to have shooting directly then, but, you know, you have to have line of sight. Okay, Kevlar is, again, Kevlar is my headshot specialist. Let's try. Headshot?
Copy that, Commander.
Nope. Not quite. We got one head hit in, though. So that's the second one. Okay.
Good to go.
I want to reserve Behemoth. Maybe we can get the second Orion. That would be nice. So I wanted to let him stand up again so that I can knock him over again with Behemoth. Please don't shoot her. Shoot the Orion, please. It's high priority. Come on, she's got it. Yes, that's exactly what I wanted. Such a tank. The Orion is such a tank. Combined with Bulwark, it's so good, guys. Get yourself a Bulwark pilot and put it in an Orion.
Ready for order.
It's so, so good. Cold shot to the leg. Makes sense to me. She is in high spirits. We do not shoot the mediums here. Just because I want to get more stability damage in. Knock him over again. Work on his leg so that if he stands up again, we can just shoot the leg again and he falls over again. That's the idea here. Okay. Center torso is almost down though. Should have killed him. Never mind. We will not get him. It's only a very, very slight chance. Okay, let's see what it is. It is a Demolisher, double AC-20. Yeah, this thing is scary. We're gonna take it out immediately. Alpha strike. Let's go. Got it. Nice.
Let's hit him hard.
Cool. More morale?
You like that?
Maybe I should get the comms booster on Glitch. I have a feeling that she's gonna take out a lot of mechs and then getting or vehicles because she's doing so many precision strikes, hard word for me, and then getting the morale back immediately would be nice. I think I'm gonna switch the components there. That makes sense to me. No, for the last enemy. No, no, no. I want to take another chance. There is one more chance that I get the Orion. And I'm gonna show you how. So, you don't do anything. He's coming in. Yeah, bring it, man. Bring it. I'm not afraid of you. Yeah, give me Kevlar, give me Precision Strike, give me the headshot. That's the last chance that I have. Anything else would kill. Yeah. Any other component. Ah, except if I hit the arm or so, but the headshot is my last chance to get it.
Roger. Target confirmed.
Oh, wait. Wait. Huh. Sightors are destroyed. We need one more knockdown. Oh my god. Can we do it from the right side? If I punch him now? Let's go.
Copy that.
Like, we have still some structure on the side and we only deal 80 damage. Hit the arm, please. I didn't get it. No! I did not get it. We shoot the legs then. Or should we... Wait, how much damage do we need? Wait. We can do the math on this. 50 damage. If we hit this thing with two medium lasers, it's gonna be enough. Ah, let's go. Let's try. Two mediums. Ah, wait. We need... This is nice. Accuracy crit. It's accuracy crit. We need exactly 50 damage. Let's not... Oh, the damage is stated here as well. So this one deals 30. We need exactly 50. Can we do it? Yes! No. Crap! I was thinking that was double side torso, but one of that actually hit the sender and we're out of combat. Alrighty, let's get out of here, guys. So, who's this? The Battlemaster. Can you... Oh, wait. Yeah, never mind. I should have taken Glitch and just jumped in here. Okay, we got it. Is there another? You're in the right area. Hold position until the samples are bored. Okay, can do. That means that we are racing and we are done.
The asset is in hand.
Get to the evac zone.
Good work.
Secure the secondary facility to rescue the operatives. Oh, there's the evac zone. Okay. We need to get in 4 units. Okay. Let's go. Jump around. Brace. And I believe that that's it for this mission here. Because we were facing a lot of big tanks and this was a 3.5 skull mission. Oh crap, do I have to? I have to go all the way around. Oh my god. The Battlemaster. Poor Battlemaster. Oh my god. A Warpath. I'm so sorry, dude. I am so sorry. He was out of position all game. Okay, we get there. Secondary objective, why not? Let's go. Run, Behemoth, run! All targets are eliminated. Sit tight and I can collect you from where you are at right now. Okay, we got it, guys. Thanks. We're out of here. Cool. That is the first mission of the day. We're gonna negotiate another one. We got some payment here. We got some damage to our mechs, but again, I like to use all of my assets on the battlefield. Not only firepower and terrain, but also my armor, and therefore just accelerating the games by just going in a little bit and, you know, making sometimes a risky move is nice to have. We got one Orion V-Par here. That's a no-brainer, taking this so that we can finish up on... What? AC20++. 10 damage, plus 10 stability damage. Hell yeah. Medium laser plus. This is a nice idea. And any gyros or something? No. Arm mod. Plus 20 melee damage. But takes 4 ton. No. That's too much. I mean, before we get into melee, the game is over already in our setup here. Yeah, that's it. Let's go. AC20++. That's gonna be a weapon for one of my next mechs. So I want to build one brawler at some time. Oh, we could put that into the Battle Master, actually. It's probably too heavy. It's most likely too heavy. Yeah. Let's see. Maybe we can bring the AC20 into some nice mech later on. At the moment, I'm relatively satisfied. But if we get an upgrade, like let's say an Atlas, we're gonna bring in an AC20. That's for sure. And now we have one already. Like the damage increase and the stability damage is just massive. Such a big impact. Haha. Impact on our gameplay. Alrighty. Lady Kentrella is ready to meet us on Weldry, Commander. I have filed a contract in the command center. Nice job. Good. So we can take on the next priority mission, but we're gonna do it the next game. Now I want to get just one more game done, because we have some time left, guys. So let's just take the next contract. It's a travel contract. War Council. Where's that? On Weldry. Is this Weldry as well? Yeah, it's a 3-skull mission, though. Capture the base. I'm not satisfied with this. I do not want to capture the base. Do I? It's so easy. I mean, let's just go somewhere and find another contract that is in our weight class. So we need... this is Weldry, right? Yeah. Okay. Shall we just go to... what's this? Fjaldr? It's 3.5, everything at 3.5, bring them. Zangul. I want to stay relatively close. Umgard. No, Smithen, 3 skulls. Magdur. Let's go to Magdur again. We just set course here. I just wanna get some stuff done. And not bother with Weldry. I mean, 3 skulls? This is below our standards. Let's go ahead and upgrade the ship. This gives me some time to show you what I did here. I was going for maximum morale. I wanted to start off with precision strikes and as many as possible. Therefore, we're gonna upgrade to the low G pool as well. I like this. So 450,000, average cost, I don't care. We have money for days. So let's get going. Let's see if we can upgrade our mech warriors as well. So Behemoth, good call for piloting here. Gets a bit of melee hit, but she's not meleeing ever. So what I want to do with her is get the Master Tactician here. So the Cold Shot Mastery. Decker, not relevant. Glitch can go for another tactics. Yes, please. Let's get the Gauss Rifle to the head sometime soon. That would be cool. Also, High Guts would be cool as well. So that we have the higher heat threshold. Makes jumping a lot easier. Let's go for this first. Alright. Kevlar. What is Kevlar running? Kevlar is running the Orion. So we definitely go for higher heat threshold here. Also, +2 health is always nice to have. I mean, eventually we will probably get to the max thing anyway. And I want to save here for another high tactics. This is my plan at the moment. And yes, you can disagree on this. Taking the headshots is... I mean, not a risky move. But an unlikely event. But 18% still, 18% chance to get a mech out immediately with one hit is gambling on RNG. I know, but it's sometimes worth it. And I like it. I like gambling. It's my playstyle. Okay, so let's keep going. Ooh, the legs. Holy crap. Hello? Game? Game? Hello? Oh my god. I'm sorry, what is this? I hope you are okay, game. I hope this was a one-time event. Okay. 8 days, let's go. Ship upgrade, 12 days. We don't get the next morale unless I wait there for 4 days. But the good thing is that we can go ahead and shop a little bit. Maybe that's it. So we're gonna shop on Magdur, because Magdur is, I believe, rich. So let's see. Maybe we can find something nice. We can find a full griffin. AC5++. +20 stability damage is huge. But AC5 doesn't have enough impact. Small laser +++. Definitely take that. Maybe for later. Just take it. Just buy it. And that's it. Alright. So let's find a contract here. A good one. Oh yeah, four skulls, ambush convoy and battle. This is what we're gonna do, guys. We go for full salvage here. And we have a full skull mission. We have 4.5. Yeah, look at this. This is, again, we are overpowered even for this mission. But maybe we find something nice on the battlefield. Oh yeah, let's go. This is gonna be fun. I'm very excited about this. So, I'm just thinking of what I want. Again, I'm very satisfied with my Thunderbolt. Don't get me wrong. This is just a 65 ton mech, but it is a mech that can load a lot of LRMs, and I want to have one LRM support in my lance at the moment. Later on, when we go full assault or so, the full Steiner Scout lance, that is what I'm working towards. We don't need LRMs that much anymore, but having the Thunderbolt right now is super convenient. The Orion is working towards its expectations, I would say. So it's all right. It's not too crazy in terms of damage output. It's relatively hot, I have to say. Maybe I'm gonna change the build at some point. And the medium lasers rack up a lot of heat. Maybe going for an AC-20 and only SRMs is the way to go there. Might be it. Might be it.
Command interface initiated.
But yeah, let's see if we can find another assault mech. Might be. Might be. Commander, you have reached the pirate family's territory. Be on the lookout for reinforcements. We'll need to eliminate all enemy forces that take the field. Don't be complacent if the mech looks a little worse for wear. They can still kill you. Okay. Yeah, we are fighting against pirates again. Pirates are good. You can get easy kills on the priority targets to take out, or on the lesser priority targets to take out first, and then 100 ton. I'm gonna save this. I don't want the game to crash here. Because in my last playthrough, I had a crash. Can I please save this? There's a 100 ton mech on the battlefield. Oh shit. Oh shit, we gotta get this. You know what that means, right? I believe there is only 100 tonner in the game. There is only 100 tonner in the game, guys. And this is an Atlas. Holy crap. I need this in my life. Let him come. Hey guys, I'm sorry. I just, my game crashed and I had to completely restart the computer. Sometimes it's just working and then I have the player is already running bug and I can't bring up the thing. Please believe me guys, this is no safe scumming. This is just me having a rough time recording this. It happened twice actually. So I really, really hope that we can play this through to the end. I want that Atlas. That Atlas is gonna be such a huge, huge upgrade for my lance. And as I said before, we have found that AC-20 plus plus, and I wanted to have an AC-20 carrier, and this Atlas is gonna be it. So let's see if we can salvage it from the battlefield. Come in here, buddy. Come in here. Oh yeah, he's shooting his LRMs to the Battlemaster. Oh my god. Okay. Yeah, it was okay because we were in cover and we have some evasive going on for us. So, what do we have here? 80 ton vehicle, might be a Shrek, might be a Demolisher, both of which are scary. So, can we get an angle on them? No, we cannot. So, I believe what we do then here is just killing this guy. Wait. look at this. The Atlas moved in turn 2. So, it means that he has Master Tactician and he's actually a scout. I realized he's just a scout. Look at this. Atlas Scout Lance. Confirmed. Okay, this is a Master Tactician. He has plus one initiative. That means he most likely does not have that much health on his pilot. So with three head injuries or pilot injuries, we could already get it. Commander. Let's go then. Let's go. Behemoth, LM30. Just shoot him. I think I'm going to shoot regularly here. It's gonna be enough to knock him over anyway, right? And a precision strike wouldn't do anything specific for us, except if we went for the leg to bring him down quickly later again. Yeah, let's work on the leg. Let's work on the leg and hopefully we, we can later precision strike him again so that he will be knocked over by just a leg destruction. But that's gonna be it. We now take Warpath with the LRM-20. This thing has also high stability damage here. And do I want to get closer? Could go here. He's getting knocked down anyway. Yeah, let's do it. Let's move a little bit. And then we use Bulwark next turn. I want the Battlemaster on the front line. I don't want the Thunderbolt to be pushed. So we could have also stayed there. I'm not shooting any medium laser here. I want this thing as fresh as possible. I only need to kill the pilot. No extra damage to the torso. It's very important. The good thing is that he is in cover. So he only takes 25% damage. That's really good. We only want the stability damage. First knockdown. Cool. Alright, enemy turn. Let's see what is happening here. There's something in the back that is coming in. Interesting. Now, we have Kevlar in glitch. Kevlar being able to technically do the cold shot to the head. Do I want to risk it? Kevlar is my sniper, my Tactician 9 pilot. Let me see. 16% hit chance. Oh god. Do we want to take the shot with the AC-10? This guy has 38 health. The AC-10 will just destroy the cockpit if we get that shot done. Let's go for it.
Roger.
Come on.
Target confirmed.
No, it was a miss completely.
No level,
what? Okay, well, that's bad, Kevlar. That's really bad. But I'm fine with it. I mean, it's better than if I hit accidentally the center torso. Because I do not want to hit center. It's very important.
I hear ya.
Oh, there's another tank. I just realized. So we have 80-ton tank on the right side. 80-ton tank here. Let's see if we can get an angle on this. We cannot. Okay. So I think then we jump over here. And we continue working on the leg, honestly. 63 plus 105 structure. It's a lot of structure. That means 75 from the Gauss. Plus 80. It's not gonna be enough to destroy the leg. And I think even if we hit the leg with all of... No, we're not gonna hit the leg with all of the damage, so it's gonna be fine. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what we want. Leg is open, and we got some more damage to this. And now the tank is coming in. I wonder what it is. It's not shooting, and there's another tank. 80 ton, oh my god. Oh my god, the tonnage. I think I have to work towards the vehicle soon. And here's how we do it. We reserve our heavy mechs to the last initiative turn. We let the Atlas stand up again. This should be his highest priority right now. It's not. Okay. Okay, the center is a little bit damaged already. And again, this is exactly what we do here. So we work towards the tanks, because they need to be off the battlefield. Okay, I want to jump, because the super evasion of glitch is just super valuable. We can evade tank on the right side. So I believe this is what we do here.
Uh-huh.
You jump over here, and you destroy this thing, please. It's a Shrek PPC carrier. Oh, yes. The good thing is that he is also in shoddy condition, which means our Gauss rifle destroys everywhere, except for the turret that has a little bit more HP. So we don't need to do a precision strike. We just go with this. This should be enough. Cool. No, that's one triple PPC carrier off the battlefield. Make the Shreks your priority, because they have three PPCs, which deal stability damage, a massive pinpoint, and they do not generate heat. This is a big drawback of the PPC. It is so massively hot. And on the tank, there is no such thing as heat management. Ooh, the Orion getting shot. Oh, that's interesting. Good thing that he is not hitting so much, I wanted to say, but actually the 20s? The missiles here. Coming in big time. I want to repeat what I've done before. Shall we go for a precision strike? I mean, I have the morale. So we go for the leg again.
Taking the shot.
I hope that I do not destroy the leg. Oh, we destroyed a leg. Okay, but we got an ammo explosion pilot injured. And then there is the knock... No, unsteady only. Yeah, sure. But wait. If you lose a leg, you should fall anyway, don't you? Isn't it an auto fall? An auto knockdown if you lose a leg? Doesn't seem like it. Okay. I didn't know that. I mean, he's unsteady. His side torso is open. He has the second pilot injury. The third is coming from the knockdown. So what I want to do here is just shoot him once more with an LRM-20 to knock him down and then destroy the side torso with a precision strike, or cold shot rather than that. Head hit? Aw, oh, only knocked down. It's fine. Pilot injured. The third pilot injury. Oh, I want this Atlas. Give it to me! And as you can see, 25% of the enemy units destroyed. That was one of the tanks. Which means that these here and the Atlas are the last remaining enemies, probably before reinforcements arrive. We're gonna see about this soon. Kevlar. Do you want to destroy the side torso? Could be... No, you go over here because you are in medium range. You can... Yeah, you can destroy the tank easily. So that's what we do. Obviously. Absolutely. Before the Shrek can do anything else, we do the precision strike to the side. Do we need this? Wait. Check the damage. AC-10++ is able to destroy reliably. At the same time, if we precision strike now, we get some morale back, so it doesn't matter. I want to be safe here. Yeah, it's overkill, I know, but still.
Okay, now
destroy the firepower. And then deal with what you want. Okay, there's another 80-ton vehicle. It's coming into line of sight now. Maybe not.
Heads up.
Ah, reinforcements have arrived. Okay, now it's getting interesting. What do we do here?
Yes,
I think... Huh. I want to reserve here.
Waiting for the right play.
The Atlas needs to stand up again. We want to knock him over once more. I do not want to take the risk of shooting the side torso off, because I am scared that the center torso will be hit. Ooh. Okay. He's not shooting his AC-20. I am so lucky. At the same time, again, this is a mega evasion. I am so happy about the gyro plus the Highlander plus glitch with the evasive move and the jumping capabilities here. This is amazing. Okay, Behemoth, do your thing. Just regular shooting. Hit. Head. Okay, not enough, but unsteady. That's what we want. Could be that the tank is coming in there. So, can we take it out before it can do any harm? It's probably possible. Yep, let's do it. Jump around. It's a demolisher. Oh, I should have stayed at range. The demolisher has more armor than the Shrek. Actually, I wanted to multi-target here. Getting the stability damage from the LRM in. And then just shooting the demolisher or the tank. The thing that is there with my Gauss rifle. I cannot do this anymore, but I still have Kevlar and Warpath to do something about the Atlas. Okay, so we have to precision strike here, and we have to alpha strike, and we go directly to the front. Yeah, let's go. Structure exposed. Vehicle down. Okay.
I feel bad about shooting the little guys.
Oh, I just realized. I do a lot of this with glitch. Did I say that before? I have a deja vu right now. Did I say that before? That glitch and the morale cockpit mod would be a nice combination? I don't know, but it might be. Okay, here's the knockdown. The good thing is that Warpath is bulwark. He can just stay there. Doing nothing. And I really hope that this is gonna be the last knockdown pilot injury for the Atlas. Yes, now we just need to survive. That's it, guys. Now we just need to survive here. Alright, how do we do it? We'll walk. Yeah, let's turn around. Race. So we have a medium mech here. It is a six. No, it's a heavy mech with tactician. 60-ton mech. All right. Dragon? Quick draw? Let's see. Let's reserve. I want to have glitch to get line of sight first, and then we follow up with the lurms here. Let's go in, glitch. Jump around. Oh, you cannot. Oh, this is disappointing. You cannot, but you can stay there. Playing the tank for the team. She had enough elevation to get line of sight on this. Oh, that's funny. Cool, brace. Maybe Kevlar can get in. Kevlar, can you do something about it? Kevlar could just run. Or we just entrench here. Let's wait for it. Wait for it. This also means that Warpath can just do a sprint to the front line. Sprint. Wow, you're so slow. You're getting slowed down by terrain so much. Holy crap. Okay, but anyway. I think this is the way to go right now.
Very slowly with the Battlemaster.
Oh, guys, we got an Atlas. We got an Atlas. Order. And you go over here.
Moving to position.
Just to be a little bit closer. I want to be actually in range when the fight starts. And then you brace as well. Alright, come in, bro. Show yourself. Okay, he's not. That means that we can reserve again. Reserving and this action. Time Glitch should be able to get line of sight, and then we're gonna unleash hell on this guy. Ya. So jump in. Exactly. So we don't want to be in close range so that our Gauss rifle can shoot. But this should be fine from here. There's a red eye. So can you see that on the line of sight here? The red eye obstructing line of sight. So we go over here. And there's another mech, which is an 80-ton mech. Holy crap, what is going on today? So let's get rid of the the quick draw here. Center torso, everything. Completely ignoring his guarded. Okay. I mean, not ignoring it. Like, I ignore it. The pilot does not. It's still guarded, but I ignore that he has that. I just want to get him off the battlefield. And there's another 90-ton mech. Oh my god. Holy crap. So much tonnage on the battlefield.
Yes, Commander.
Okay. Okay. Your Warpath. You can actually get there. So let's do it. Let's use Warpath. Since Warpath can get direct line of sight. We are out of range for the medium still. That's okay. That's fine. I think it's actually better doing it like this than shooting the mediums. Because of the heat generation. Where you want to have some spare heat when the big ones are coming in. Oh wow. What was that? Seriously, why LRM-15? Who is shooting LRM-15 there?
What's up, boss?
Shall you go a little bit further? Could just stay here? But again, my range is relatively limited. I want her to be a little bit further ahead. Just a little bit. And then she can use Bulwark as her passive ability to get 50% guarded later. Okay. Precision strike. We will get the morale back anyway. I want the quick draw off now. Don't want to take any chances here. Okay, CT destroyed. Pilot incapacitated.
Might be some good salvage there.
That's a lot of tonnage here. And I wonder what we are going up against. So an 80-tonner. 80-tonner, Victor? Victor? Yeah, I think Victor is 80. What else is 80? Awesome? Kevlar. Sprint?
Alright.
So my Orion and my Highlander are gonna be my frontliners, and of course the Battlemaster. So I want them somewhat close. Okay, we're gonna see about this. It is an awesome, okay, PPC carrier. Ooh, the hits. One went to the center, one went to the side torso. This is fine. We're gonna do this now. Shooting only the right side. And he has a lot of stability threshold. I actually might not be able to knock him down in one turn. Anyway, let's go for it. We gotta kill him anyway. I think I'm not gonna go to try to salvage this guy here. Since I definitely want the Atlas, so there's no need for me to actively try to knock him down and get this thing done. You over here. I want to reserve her. I'm gonna do this. Going forward. Oh crap. Just the second Atlas? Wait, what?
Damage minor.
Wait, what? I need to kill him. I need to do it quickly. Super quickly. Like mega quickly.
Location confirmed.
Oh my god. What is this? Headshot. 100%. With everything. Can I see this, please? So maybe my AC-10 is killing this. If not, it's at least knocking him down. Oh, what the lag. No. Okay.
Scored a critical hit.
That means that Glitch can follow up and do the center torso stuff. Pilot injured, at least. And here comes the 90 tonner. It's a Banshee. No, a Highlander, sorry, but a Highlander. Oh, wow. Guys, this is gonna be a tough fight. This went from a walk in the park into a fight in an MMA cage. LRM 20 PPC, of course it's a Highlander. And this is gonna be another Atlas? Like, what 100 ton max? King Crab! I forgot about the King Crab! Oh my god! There are King Crabs in this game, of course! Holy. Okay. Hey, Battlemaster. Can you... Oh my god, how do we play this? So, first of all, Awesome needs to get down. So, you need to jump? Do we jump before we shoot, or do we jump after we shoot? Doesn't matter, right? Same hit chances. 123 damage is what we need. We have a good chance to hit this guy. 123. 75. 100. 125. Let's not shoot the mediums here. Because I want to save the heat. One medium. No medium. It's fine. It's fine. Okay. Heat saved. It's good. And we definitely want to jump to cover. Alright, let's jump. Lots and lots of evasion. And I want to torso twist here. Like this. Because my center torso is already severely damaged. And I want the next damage to go to the armor side torso. Oh wow. Oh wow. Alright, Warpath, get in there. I think we're gonna destroy this guy as well. He's a recon. It's actually an assault scout lance. This is so hilarious. Alright, let's just do this. I cannot do anything else, so... The LRM at least. Side torso seems critical. That's good, because we can take out the PPC on the right arm. Is there... Yeah, PPC on the right arm. Okay. Sadly, wasn't enough to knock him down. So, what... I want to bring... You know what? I want to bring the Thunderbolt to the front as well. Do I? Thunderbolt is my squishiest mech. At the same time, he didn't get least damage. So, I want to be in medium laser range at some point. Therefore, getting the Thunderbolt in. Sure, why not? Shoot everything. Precision strike. To the side. Taking off the firepower. Yeah, let's do it. Maybe. I mean, this thing has a lot of structure still. But we got it! Nice! Cool! That is a PPC off the battlefield. Only an LRM-20 and an SRM-6 is exactly what we need here. Just removing firepower. Okay, and now Kevlar can come in. Kevlar can try to do the... Nah, she's gonna stay here and bulwark. But you know what? I want to take my chances again. Kapow.
Affirmative.
Nope. It's enough to knock him down, though. Alarm 20 is crit. Alarm 20 is destroyed. So the Highlander is basically out of the fight. He only has an SRM-6 and he is too far for too far away for meleeing. And of course, he's injured. So, we can try to gamble this. Maybe, like, getting the Atlas as the priority salvage. And then hoping that we get another Assault Mech. Maybe the Highlander. This is fine for me. Discarded. This mission has taken a completely different dynamics than I thought it would have. Holy moly. I was hoping, or I was expecting, minor reinforcements there. Okay. You jump. Where to? Wait, jump. Jump over here and see what's up there. It is a king crab! Oh yeah, look at this beauty. This is such a beautiful mech. I love the design. Now, what to do against the King Crab? We're gonna leg it. We are going to leg it. I mean, hand hit. Again, 5% chance only. But no, no, no. We are going to leg it. Let's go.
Commencing Alpha Strike.
Good stability damage. Oh, this is actually perfect for us. Like, look at this. Okay, he's gonna dissipate some stability damage now. He's only at what? AC-20 to the side.
Internal structure damage.
Holy moly, that King Crab. Yeah, I was running double AC-20, large laser, LRM-50. Okay. Granted. Alright. It's cool. It's fine. We're gonna pull Kevlar back, it's no problem. She needs one turn to get back. We still have this guy on the battlefield, right? So let's fire everything. Let's just get this Highlander off. And then we try to maybe get the King Crab. Okay. Ammo explosion pilot injured. But he's not dead yet. So we have a stick running around. This is a zombie mode. No arms, no side torsos, but still dangerous.
Waiting for orders.
Okay. Now what do we do with the King Crab? He is unsteady, so we can knock him. We are engaging from... We do not have... What? Wait, what? Behemoth? Are you actually out of range here? Are you out of range? No, you can hit this. Okay, but I don't see the circle. Anyway, so precision strike side. Let's go for this. Okay. Why am I doing this? Because I want to knock him down, right? Don't hit the leg. Okay, that's fine. He's only unsteady. Oh, actually, he shook it off. Damn it. Should have taken more attention to this. I'll paid more attention to this. Now, I'm doing this because Kevlar now can pull back over here. And torso twist hard into this direction. Left torso is open, yeah. So, we're gonna do this and she's gonna take out the Highlander. Here we go. Just with this. Yeah, the AC, if it hits, deals massive damage, and then the SRM and some medium lasers as follow-up. It hits a leg! Could you not? Oh my god. This Highlander. Okay. It's fine. Warpath, staying here. King Crab. King Crab is super scary. We take off the side here. We can do it with glitch, probably. Only indirectly, so we have to jump around a little bit. Let's jump over here. Seems good to me. I want to engage from the left side here. Ow, too hot. Because I want the side torso off. Let's go. Side torso off means two things. First of all, Another pilot injury. Secondly, AC-20 in the arm is also down. So now we can follow up with our Battlemaster. Alright. King Crab is standing up again. Oh. Don't kill me.
I'm hit.
Ow. SRM 4++, SRM 6++ down, and a head injury, which is absorbed by our cockpit mod. Oh, of course. What do we do here? Should we just destroy it? Makes sense to me. Okay. Let's just go. Should have done it earlier. Okay. Leg destroyed. Knockdown. I mean, now it's looking a little bit different. It's a skirmisher. What is a skirmisher doing? Having a high piloting skill? And high gunnery skill, I believe.
I'm here.
Ow. Okay, it's time for you to retaliate this. Just take it. Pilot injured. Okay. Behemoth?
Yes.
Can you do me a favor? Can you go for the other side also? Greedy Baradol is greedy.
Confirmed.
It's gonna be overkill though. Yeah, CT destroyed. It's gonna be overkill. It's fine. Alright. Now we have a Highlander on the battlefield. Took out my plus weapons. Bam. Oh, the Highlander has a lot of punch.
Okay,
115 melee damage.
Bad.
Crazy.
Commander?
You know what? No, wait, move. I can do the same to you. Alright, that should be it. Cool! Oh, that was fun. I mean, my Orion got some punishment, but we got some good salvage off the battlefield. Holy crap. And I mean King Crab. Double AC-20. Now, mission complete. No money. This Orion needs to be fixed. Medium lasers, SRM. Yeah, it's nothing critical that we lost. We can rebuild it. And it might be that we replace the Orion anyway with... so beautiful. An Atlas D. I definitely want the King Crab next. Like, I want to build this. AC-20 plus. Plus 20 stability damage. Oh my god. Plus arm mods. Gyros. Oh man, I really hope I get something good here. Medium laser. SRM 4++, so I can replace this thing. That's good. We got a gyro plus. Nice. And that's it. Oh, we got an Atlas, guys. Yes. This is cool. This is cool. Let's take a look at the Atlas before we go over to the finish of the video. I want to see what we can possibly do with it. I mean, the stock loadout is already pretty good. It comes with an AC-20, it comes with an LRM-15, and then the medium lasers and the SRM-6, of course. The problem that the Atlas has in stock loadout is the heat management. So, we're gonna see. Look at this. Oh yeah. Let's take a look at this beauty. So, heat management is it's only 4 bars here, but firepower is so massive. It's not 15, it's a 20. I'm sorry guys, it's a 20 LRM. And yeah, I think I'm gonna build an AC-20 carrier out of this. It just makes sense because we have either +2 accuracy or +10 damage and stability damage. This is gonna be a hard trade-off here. I think I'm gonna take this though, because it's just +++. And we could take both, technically. We could just do this. Imagine this being AC-20 ammo. Double AC-20 medium lasers. Sounds fun to me, but I'm gonna fiddle around with that a little bit off screen, and I'm gonna see you guys tomorrow then, when we not only bring an atlas to the battlefield, but also take on the new story mission. So guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm sorry for the cut in between. Couldn't do anything because the game crashed on me. I'm sorry for this. But if you enjoyed the video, then don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I hope to see you tomorrow. Goodbye.